In the first season, Lenny was trying to come to terms with, should I be the Pope or not? In this, it's almost, am I the Messiah or not? It's taking it up a notch and some. It felt right that we had to push the boundary and take it further. So the idea that he returns or wakes up or comes back, or rises from the dead and is then considered to be Father, Son, Holy Spirit, Christ, Antichrist. They don't know what he is. I don't think he knows what he is.
You do know it's a miracle that you woke up.
Please, let's not start that again.
The new Pope, John Paul III, is a great believer in the middle way, which is the way where you avoid drama and take your time. And I think Lenny learns a great lesson from that.
What a glorious Pope, John Paul III.
My feeling is Lenny now has a much better relationship with God. And I think feels like he has a direct line that he calls quite regularly.
I came back. Now tell me why.
Sophia is a genuine representation of the modern and free woman. She is not afraid of men, and she says what she thinks.
Are you embarrassed about your teeth? Covering your mouth like that when you laugh?
What a superior woman.
At the same time, she's very feminine, seductive, intelligent, funny. So she has all the weapons, and she is strong enough to position herself in this micro-society only directed by men.
If you become Pope, liberty is the one outfit you won't be able to wear.
But will I be able to see you every day?
Her relationship with the Pope is very beautiful because her optimism and her enthusiasm make the Pope feel better because he's secretly suffering. He will have great faith in her, and she will be completely charmed by him. So it will be very hard for them to keep distance from each other.
Esther has to deal with so much pain. Everybody that she thinks she can trust betrays her.
You've all abandoned me.
Lenny is between life and death. And she's completely lost because she got dumped by her husband. She's alone with her child.
Is your son the birthday boy?
Yes.
Fabiano is a very mysterious man. He's just lost his wife, and Esther thinks that their loneliness might link them somehow. And suddenly she falls in love with Fabiano. She thinks she can trust him, but he pushes her to do bad stuff. She has been punished for being too gullible.
You're back.
It's like she was addicted to belief. She has to believe in someone, in something. And suddenly everything fell apart. She represents the idea of when one is completely helpless, one can become really weak and make the wrong decisions.
Whoever believes in me should follow me.
The first series ends with Lenny Belardo falling into a coma.
Quindi si vive una condizione un po' paradossale di avere un papa in coma e di avere un altro papa invece attivo in azione.
That's it, Holy Father. We are done.
What? No nudes.
Sir John Brannox è un alto prelato inglese, un uomo nobile, un uomo decadente.
He's a complicated man. He has all kinds of wounds from his childhood when his twin brother Adam died.
E i difetti sono tutti privati. È un uomo sovrastato da una serie di dolori che lo inibiscono e lo rendono molto debole.
My parents charted a great ecclesiastical career for my brother Adam, but not for me. They told me every day of my life that I'd never amount to anything.
My character's parents saw the brother as someone who could easily have become Pope one day. That was the dream for the twin brother. He probably spends his life attempting to make up for that.
All my life, I have negated myself to alleviate your suffering. I will be Pope. Me, not Adam!
Sir John Brannox è un uomo che si è sempre sentito un secondo, e proprio quest'uomo, chiamato a fare il secondo, cioè il successore di un papa che è ancora vivo, probabilmente percepisce che questa è l'occasione per o diventare primo finalmente o spezzarsi per sempre.
I can imagine how strange it would be to become pope because a pope is in a coma. Rather than cementing your place, you feel the earth moving under your feet.
If you become pope, liberty is the one outfit you won't be able to wear.
But will I be able to see you every day?
Sophia's effect on him is to make him want to be better, so that she'll be approving of him or proud of him.
Pardon my vulgarity, sir, but she is a beauty.
They want to know if he's a kind of man of steel, because he's not Lenny. He doesn't have that authority or cult status.
Il personaggio di Jude Law è uno che ritiene essere papa una vera e propria missione. Invece il personaggio di Malkovich ritiene che il papato possa essere più un'opportunità per curarsi delle ferite.
Our mission is to protect the fragile. Wherever there is fragility, there is the church. That is who we are.
My character Bernardo thinks that Pius XIII is a real saint, and he's always thinking that maybe Pius XIII is watching us, maybe Pius XIII is going to wake up.
What would Pius XIII say? We have forgotten about Pius XIII.
In this second season, he's asking why the church has these problems with homosexuality and love. Why can't I be a normal human being in this world?
Love is an abstract concept, but a necessary one, like God.
He's a very simple guy, but he suffered. He was suffering, and he knows that he doesn't want to suffer again. And he's speaking aloud about what happened with the church. Why do we have this amount of problems and none of them have done anything about it?
God does not deny anyone the grace of salvation. It is the most beautiful thing there is.
Insomma, l'abbiamo lasciato nella disperazione come un po' tutti i fedeli, cercando di intuire lo Spirito Santo cosa vuole da noi.
You don't understand because you have given in to your emotions, but we must listen to the Holy Spirit.
Sarà un Boiello sempre più politico e sempre più sentimentale, affettuoso. Lo vediamo in tutta la sua fragilità umana. Ma arriverà al suo compimento massimo.
You will always count Boiello. Popes will come and go, but you will remain.
Lenny non ha mai avuto un rapporto con Boiello. La concretezza di Boiello per lui è sempre stato un elemento di disturbo, di fastidio probabilmente. Però forse di fondo c'è una simpatia reciproca forte, insomma, perché comunque sia, poi non si libera mai del tutto di me, ecco.
I intend to spark a revolution.
An old obsession of yours.